this is your client. The person who might come to you. Oh, that's so sad. And they're on this island. This is a palm tree. Oh, it's just got no palm. It's terrible. It's so sickly. And then, so this is sort of island A, and this is where they have a problem. Life is terrible. And then over here, this is island B, and here, oh, they're so happy. Yay! And there's a palm tree, but it's like, these markers are so great. Dude, it's mint. Whatever that is. I stopped sniffing them, and then people told me they were not toxic, so I went back on it. Don't you judge me. Okay. That's a palm tree. I'm super particular about my colors. Alright. Anyways, life is good. And here they are, and they unfortunately have in between them, between island A and island B, there's this water that they just can't seem to get over. Yeah. And so this is like present, this is them in the present, this is future them. Oh, future them. I leave most of my problems for future me. Some people call it procrastinating, but I'm like, no. I'm leaving this problem for future me. Future me is wiser, more capable of handling the problem. It would be irresponsible of me to try to handle this right now. Besides, what will future me do with his time if I don't give him things to do? That's funnier to me than it is to
me. Not when you're cancering. Procrastination is a favorite word.
Alright. So you've got this ocean here. They can't get over it. And they feel really stuck. Does it make sense generally? Yeah. This could be anything. This, by the way, this problem is usually going to fit into one of four categories. There are three kinds of people in the world. People who can count and people who can't. you'll start to find my jokes funny. Yeah. Really. You will laugh louder throughout the weekend. Do you know why they only made one Yogi the Bear?
What's that?
Do you know why they only made one Yogi the Bear? They tried again, but they made a boo-boo.
Oh.
Yeah, you'll use it later. Yeah. All right. So, almost every problem is going to fit into one of these four. So many colors to choose from. So, category number one. The little heart relationship stuff. Category number two. Health, you know, there's going to be health stuff. It's a carrot, in case you couldn't tell.
Money.
Money, right?
Money.
Money. And then I don't know what to do for this one, but like,
self.
There's sort of spirituality, God. Meaning, the deeper.
Mark.
Oh, good one. Oh,
there you go.
Oh, thank you. Top of the class. All right. So again, we've got relationships, health, money, spirituality. They're going to fit into one of those categories. We'll come back to those categories later. Yeah, that clear? It's simple. It's good. It's basic. And so they have one of these problems. Often it's an overlap, but there's usually something that's predominant for them in that moment with that particular thing. And they want to get here. Island A to Island B. And here you are. And you've got this boat. Oh, should never never stand on the road. It's very dangerous. And this boat represents your modality, your business, whatever it is. And what's important here is nobody cares about your boat. Nobody cares. They only care about your boat if they get that it can take them from island A to island B. Period. Outside of the context of that journey, it's really irrelevant to them. So when we get really excited about our, you know, oh, I do this unique combination of Reiki, Shiatsu, Traeger, and the work that reconnects a little bit of AD with quantum touch, you know what I'm saying? It's like, people don't care about the boat. We'll talk more about this tomorrow. They care about whether it can get them from here to there. So when we talk about marketing, everything in our marketing has to relate to this to this journey for people. If it does not relate to it and speak to this directly, it's like a...
Why bother?
It's, what does this mean to me? Why should I spend all this money on helping you develop your fancy boat? You know. But if they get that I can help them take that journey, then they're going to want to invest. Two things that are going to be important also in helping them understand the nature of this journey. The first is that it can be good sometimes to break the journey up into a few chunks. I think three chunks is a good place to start. You know, there might be more, but if you can say, like, you know, for example, for this weekend workshop, breaking it up into 3 days. So the first chunk of this is we're going to be taking a look at the big picture of marketing. We're going to look at understanding what this journey is. We're going to be getting to know each other. That's the first chunk. Second chunk, here, number two, in the middle, we're going to be looking at the 10 things that you must have for your marketing as a holistic practitioner, the non-negotiable foundational strategies and tools you need to apply. And those are going to be things like your website, a specialization, a way of describing what you're doing, your client list, etc., that type of thing. Third chunk we're going to be looking at is the 10 options, the most effective tactics there are, and which ones are the best fit for you. So those are going to be things like public speaking, writing, social media, PR, hosting parties, networking, choosing, all that kind of stuff. And we're going to look at what those are, pick the top two or three that are going to be perfect for you, and figure out how you can take the first steps to applying it. Yeah? So breaking it into steps sometimes makes it a little easier for people to get, rather than just, energy from the universe pours from my hands. So
don't you judge us.
Just saying. So steps is one of it. Giving people just a sense that there's a direction to it. And then also, underlying this is this idea of your point of view. And the point of view is really important. This is kind of the underlying rationale behind what you do. It's the reasons why you do what you do. For example, if I were to have you each come up here and say, I want you to talk about what do you think is the nature of illness. Some of you would get up here and you would say, illness is really about toxicity in excess of toxicity in the body. Somebody else might say, well, that's very nice and generic. I'm sure you read Fit for Life back in the 80s. That's very nice. But really, it's about acidity in the bloodstream. Yes, there's toxicity, but there was also acidity in the bloodstream, which changes the pH of the blood. And all illness really comes from that. Other people say, that's very sort of physical of you. Obviously, though, the body has its own resources to get rid of all those toxins, but it's stress that keeps our body holding that. And so really, stress is the cause of all disease. And somebody else would say, that's so this body of you. Really, it's an inconsistency between the will of the soul and the will of the personality. That's really illness. And somebody else would say, that's very this lifetime of you. It's obviously karma, past, you know. But everyone would have a different point of view of what that is. And that point of view matters. Because if the point of view doesn't make sense to people, you're going to